Hi everyone and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM 2. So, let's continue where we left off. I hope we're going to get a second engineer sometime soon, because only having one kind of sucks. Anyway, let's continue scanning, see what awaits us next. We still need to finish the rookies, so let's do that. And, oh, nice. Hey, we got the guy who balanced legend difficulty. That's Mark. Let's try to not get him killed. We'll see how that goes. So, 3 new rookies, very nice. Alright then. What else can we do? Can't go here yet. We can go make intel, we can make contact with new territory. Do we want to do that? I suppose we should. Maybe. How much intel do we actually have? 140. Yeah, that should be more than enough. I think we can make contact with new territory. Well, we should make contact with India then, because, you know, that's where the black site is. And that's our actual objective. Make contact with India. Let's go do that. What's up, India? That will take 5 days. That's fine. Proving ground is done. Nice one. So now the problem is, we only have one engineer, so I can't really use this slot right now because I want to get started on other facilities. Which means we have to remove the debris. But let's check the proving ground real quick. So, if we assign the engineer here, that's project speed plus 50%. Oh yeah, we need the Skulljack to actually capture a live advent officer. We can also make experimental ammo and experimental grenades from Ellerium cores. So that's what the Ellerium cores are used for. I can't tell you how useful these things are going to be because I have no idea. Right, so we don't need her here. We can still start a project, it will just take a while. I guess we should get started on the Skulljack, but that's 50 supplies. Maybe it can wait a little bit. I think it can wait a little bit. I want to try experimental ammo or experimental grenade. Yeah, let's try the experimental grenade. Why not?
Get started immediately, Commander.
Done.
You know, as soon as we've made progress.
All right. So, now. Right, we can still work on that without the engineer here, right? Yes, we can. Because I want to start clearing the alien debris and build more facilities. There are quite a few really important facilities. So let's get started on that. That will take 5 days. And hopefully we'll get an engineer from one of the missions. We really need more than one engineer. One engineer is just not enough. And hybrid materials research is done. That unlocks the nanoscale vest, which gives you more health and goes in the same slot the grenades go in. And we can research plated armor if we want to. We probably don't want to. Yeah, 20 days and 10 alien alloys cost. What can we research? We could go for magnetic weapons. We should do some of these autopsies. I think intel can wait. This will give us intel. Resistance radio. Yeah, let's go for the autopsy, because we'll need the autopsy anyway. Might as well do that, and that's only 3 days. And, well, back to making contact with India. What's going on? Oh, I think I know what's going on.
Our pleasure, Den Mother. Enjoy it while it lasts.
We plan to.
Yeah, I know what's going on.
Massive signal coming from the Advent Network Tower. It's global. Sir, I think you want to see this.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years, the Advent Coalition has worked tirelessly to repair the ravages and injustices of the old world. Under our stewardship, our cities prosper, our people flourish, and our world heals.
And yet,
among us, there are still those who would refuse to acknowledge the truth, who are determined to see all that we have achieved.
Multiple radar contacts on approach to Haven Alpha 7.
That must end. speak to you today.
You've got incoming on approach.
Your signal's breaking up.
Outlying territories to end this scourge once and for all.
They're right on top of you.
Losing you, Avenger.
Raise them again.
We will ensure your continued safety and well-being throughout this crisis.
Yep. So this is going to be a retaliation mission. Basically, this is XCOM 2's equivalent of terror missions.
And usher in another 20 years of peace and prosperity.
They don't stand a chance. Commander, we should get a squad ready to deploy.
Yep, doesn't look like they're having a fun time. And this thing, that's the faceless. Not so pleasant, let's just say. Yep, retaliation. Alright, let's go then. So the main difference between a terror mission and a retaliation mission is that you actually have to save a certain number of civilians or you will fail. Now. Yeah, this is the facility we need to increase our squad size. That's why I wanted to clear that alien debris. Anyway, let's remove all of these guys and try to bring the strongest squad we can. Let's have a look. Joe is wounded. We need at least one grenadier. I'm actually tempted to bring two grenadiers. It's just such a good class. Yeah, we could go for two grenadiers and Ranger. We could bring Jane. I want to bring Mark. Yeah, to get him promoted. Okay, Mark, you're coming. And one more person. We could bring a ranger, I suppose. Or I could just bring Neil. I mean, this might not be an easy mission. It's probably not going to be an easy mission. Alright, this is fine. We need to make items available. And we will grab the flashbang grenade. Can we not grab the flashbang grenade? Who has the flashbang grenade? Oh yeah, we already got one here. I could make one more, but I think this will be fine. We do need a medkit on someone. Probably on Neil, because it's not like he's going to use that grenade all that much. He's a sniper after all. So yeah, we will go for a medkit on Neil. That seems fine. And looks like that's it. We don't really have a lot of choices here. Hey Mark, try to not die. Alright, we're ready. This should be a fun mission. Do we have some mods? I think we still have some mods. Yeah, we can give him extra aim. Sure, let's give him extra aim. Alright, looks good. Let's go then, looking forward to this. So-called peacekeepers, yeah, well said. Hey, let's keep peace by killing people. Seems legit. So obviously, this is a randomly generated map. Which might lead to a fairly easy mission or to a really damn hard mission.
Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
Yeah, yeah, we'll do what we can. No promises. Alright. Well then, let's move. So we will have a faceless here. Which is, these guys are a civilian at first. Which means any civilian can be a faceless. Okay, I see some civilians in this general direction. We have to rescue at least 6 civilians, otherwise we will fail the mission. So, we need to move quickly. I think it would be a good idea to dash. But we can stay on high ground for now. I think that's going to be better. Yeah, let's stay on the high ground.
On the move.
Brian over here, and that leaves us with Neil. Neil could stay up here, but he will need line of sight. Obviously. Well, let's go like this for now, and we'll use Overwatch. Because we are not actually concealed, as you might have guessed. And, yep, they will start killing civilians already. And all the civilians actually have names, which is really interesting. I like that. We have to stop this. So it's not civilian 1, civilian 2, civilian 3, they actually have names, you know. Right, well, we need to move. We could save one person right away. It's not necessarily a brilliant idea to dash there, but there is cover, and we would save that person. Okay, let's do it. We need to move quickly, or we will fail. So there, we saved one. 5 more to go. Let's move. We will use Overwatch. Like this. Mark can move into cover, and we will keep Neil up here. In full cover. I like that plan. And Overwatch. Affirmative. Covering now. I don't want to move too quickly. Yeah, there are quite a few civilians on the left side. Oh, damn it. Yeah, this is going to be bad. We need to hurry up there. Or all of these people are going to die. I think we should move in this direction. Looks like there are at least 2 groups over there. Any more civilians? I don't see any in this area. That kind of sucks. Okay, let's go. Move quickly. Come on, guys. Neil needs to move over. I don't necessarily want to trigger that group right now, but I'm not sure. Let's move like this. There's a chance this will trigger something. Nope. So this person is going to die. There's probably no way around that. Yeah, I don't think so.
On the move.
Alright. Not much we can do about that. But let's move as much as possible. Come on, Mark. By the way, that camouflage probably isn't very effective. I'm just saying.
On the move.
Not that I got anything against pink. Yep, these people are going to die. Oh, that's a faceless. Alright then. That's somewhat unpleasant. So the faceless are pretty dangerous. And they are pretty big. And this person will die, damn it. Yep. Well, I couldn't have saved her. But we still need to save 5 more civilians. Yes, I noticed. Thanks for the update, Bradford. How about you get over here and save them yourself, eh? If you are so smart. By the way, this thing has a pretty long range. Well, as in, pretty long range for a melee range. As you can see, it doesn't have to stand right next to you. And we almost got killed over there. That's not a brilliant start. We do have a medkit. But that's just one medkit. Okay, that thing has to die. 99%. Okay, Neil. Don't beat the 1%. Thanks. Come on, bro. Okay, nice. 4 damage. How much more do we need? 6 more damage. Yeah, they got 10 health. Not so good. We need to not miss. That's pretty important. Okay, Brian, you're up. Don't miss. You're allowed to kill it. There, he actually did. Good job. Now, I think we need to do some healing. Yes, we do. 1 health is not so great. Most of the time. So, we can heal him up on the next turn. That's what we're going to do. There is going to be a group on the left side here. So I think it's best to just prepare for it. Oh yeah, we can save a person over here. Let's do that. There, 2 out of 6 saved. Okay then. Hi. We found the group. Or it found us. This might be slightly problematic. Can we actually kill them both? Maybe, maybe not. And another dead civilian. If all the civilians are on the other side of the map, this might be a little bit tough. Come on. So, how can we do this? I think we'll have to use a grenade. Probably. I think a grenade will be the best choice here. What about Mark? He can't do anything useful. What's the range? If we move close enough, we might be able to throw a grenade. Are there some civilians in this area? Yeah, I can see one person. Over here. I don't really want to trigger anything, but I really want to save people. Still, I think we can throw a grenade. From here. Let's try. Yeah, we can. We can hit them both. No, if I want to hit them both, I have to use the Grenadier. I think it's worth it. Okay, let's do it. Did I mention Grenadiers are really damn good? Because they are. Such a great class early on. Okay, I was really hoping to do 4 damage instead. But we might be able to kill both of these guys. In fact, we can shoot them both in the face. However, that doesn't always work. Healing will have to wait. We need to kill them.
Roger that.
Okay, Bjorn. You're not allowed to miss this. You hear me? Don't miss. There, that's a kill. We have the grenade as our backup plan. But it looks like we won't be needing a backup plan. And we got some loot. Nice. Autoloader. Oh, that sounds really useful.
I've got it.
Now, we have to kill that other guy. Let's not stand too close to him, because if we miss, we will be able to get a kill with a grenade. That wouldn't necessarily be the best use of a grenade of all times, but it would give us a kill. Come on, Neil, don't waste our grenades. Oh, he has 100, alright. Never mind. Done. Okay, now we need to go rescue more civilians. We still need to rescue 4 more. Let's go back towards that person over there. Sounds good. Okay. Yeah, there's a group on the other side of the map. And there are quite a few civilians over there. They actually missed. But I think that person is screwed. Okay, and there's a group over here. That's much closer. I have a feeling this will be really close. There are only 6 civilians remaining. Yeah, I don't know about this. We might not be able to do this. Well, let's get this person over here at least.
Go, get out of here.
There are 2 civilians inside the building. I don't know, man. There's one person on the right side. There's no way we're going to get all 3, that's just not going to happen.
Moving to designated position.
And we still need to do some healing. I want to move. Let's try to do both. We can do both.
Heading there now.
Come on, Neil. Doesn't really matter
Understood.
Where he's going to
moving
stand.
Out.
He will be moving on the next turn. So heal up and then we can move one more time. We need to hurry up. If the aliens kill more than 2 civilians, we will fail this mission. And that wouldn't be so good.
Rolling.
Do we want to dash? It should be Moving safe to dash like this into full cover. Okay, and Mark can also move. Yeah, I want to move towards that person on the right side. Let's go. I think we can save him or her on the next turn. Yeah, there's a group here. This is bad. I'm moving as fast as I possibly can.
It's turning into a massacre.
Yes, we know,
there, Commander.
Central.
That camp is getting wiped out.
How about you get over here and help us?
Admin for society.
Okay, here's a group. Hi. That's 4 civilians just in this area. Alright then. So, it would be nice to kill both of these guys. I can launch a flashbang grenade, and Mark has a grenade. Do we want to throw that grenade? We probably do. it might kill the Advent Trooper, or it might not. The problem is that even if we kill the Advent Trooper, the sectoid is just going to reanimate him, and our other dudes are on the other side. But we do have a shot, apparently. Or do we? No, we don't have a shot. Why would we? Where do we want to go? Let's just dash as much as possible with Neil. So, do we want that flashbang grenade? Can we launch a grenade from here or so? I could see that happening, yeah. Like this? Let's try. I really want to try killing both the sectoid and the Advent Trooper. Well, we can almost do it. Will this also hit the sectoid? Where exactly is the sectoid? I can't see the sectoid anymore. Alright, let's just move around a bit. There's the sectoid, so can we hit the sectoid with the frag grenade? No, we can almost do it, but not quite. Damn it. Okay, hold on, we might be able to do it after all. If we blow up this wall, at least partially, we might be able to use the frag grenade better. I will throw this grenade anyway, because that gives us a chance to kill the Advent Trooper, and we failed. But we did demolish the wall, so now we should be able to use the frag grenade, can we? I think so. We can hit the sectoid. That's all we can really do. I can move up and either take a shot or launch a flashbang grenade. This is going to be so close. I think we have to take a risk. I wouldn't want to waste that grenade, but if we kill the sectoid, we could then use the grenade to get a guaranteed kill on the Advent Trooper. It would be a bit of a waste of the grenade, but whatever. I could also hit the sectoid with the grenade, but I can't hit both. I can only hit one or the other. We got 78% chance. If we miss, this is going to suck. Come on, bro. And okay, we killed it. Nice. Good job. So now we can use the grenade launcher. I hope this will be worth it. We can kill that guy. This is going to be a guaranteed kill. So go, go, go. We got 4 civilians just in this area. If we save 3 of them and then kill all the remaining enemies, obviously, then we will finish the mission. But we have to save 3 more. And we don't know just how close the other group is. I mean, we kind of know, but it will obviously be moving. Let's just dash towards that person.
Rolling.
Well, there's no need, I don't think so. There's no group nearby, there's no need to dash. Okay, let's not run through the fire. Is that civilian standing literally inside the fire? No, kind of. It's the wall that's on fire, but he's kind of standing in the fire. What the heck are you doing? Please stop.
On my way.
It's bad for your health.
Why are you just
there.
Standing around?
Yeah, that was kind of weird. Alright. Whatever floats his boat. Or her. We got 2 people over here. We just need 1 of them. Let's dash into nice full cover. And we need to jump down. I don't want to move too aggressively. Because while I want to save these people, I don't want to trigger an alien group right now. Okay, and we got Bjorn. I think we can do this. Any cover over here? Not really. Yeah, let's just stay back here and we lose Overwatch. We still got 1 more grenade. Grenadiers are just so good. We need more of these guys. Right, what are the odds that there's a group right here? Probably low. And I want to move to the left with Mark on the next turn. Let's just save this person. There. Nice. I think we can do this. And they are coming. Okay, but we just need to save one more person and then kill the aliens, obviously. And we do have Overwatch. Come on, hit the sectoid. Go, go. Nice. Perfect. He's down to 2 health. And we have a frag grenade. Is this going to be the last group? I have no idea. It might be. And we still have the flashbang grenade. Let's go for the safe option and use the frag grenade. This will kill the sectoid, and it will either kill the advent trooper or it should destroy his cover. There. Come on. Awesome. It didn't kill him. But we should be able to kill him quite easily. Alright, and there's a civilian over here apparently. So we can move in and then take a shot. Surely someone will hit that guy. There, he's dead. Any more groups or are we actually done?
Good riddance.
Are we done?
Menace 1-5, status confirmed.
Yes, we're done. Nice one. I was worried for a moment at the start of the mission. But that was really good. I think it was partially thanks to our 2 grenadiers. Like, without so many grenades, this would have been significantly harder. But we did it. 100% successful shot percentage. RNGesus was on our side, and Mark moved the furthest. Well, he will get a promotion. No one was most under fire. That's pretty funny. Hey, successful retaliation is successful, I would say. One person will be wounded, but oh well. That's not a big price to pay for a mission like this. There. Alright, so let's check Mark. What class are you going to be? A specialist. Hey, that's good. I only had one specialist. And these guys are pretty useful for hacking and other things. Next up, we got Brian's promotion. We got demolition. Unleash a volley of bullets at your target's cover, significantly damaging or destroying it. Deals no damage to your target. And suppression. Well, suppression is the same, I assume. Pins down the target, granting reaction fire against it if it moves. Minus 50 penalty to target's aim. This is such a tough choice, actually. Demolition sounds amazing. But suppression is always useful as well. The demolition is going to be amazing when we run out of grenades. Or when we won't actually have a grenadier. Well, this is a grenadier, but it will be super useful when we run out of grenades. On the other hand, I also like suppression. But suppression is kind of a defensive ability. And there are quite a few timed missions. So because there are so many timed missions, I'm leaning more towards demolition, because that's a more aggressive ability. It doesn't sound like it's guaranteed to destroy cover, but yeah, this is going to be huge. Let's go for demolition. Done. And one more person. Shredder or blast padding? I think we'll go for Shredder. Alright, Shredder it is then. He will be gravely wounded for only 9 days, alright. That's a good roll, I assume. And we're done. We got an autoloader. The first reload in a mission does not cost an action. That's amazing. And we got a faceless corpse and some other corpses. So, from what I know, corpses are pretty damn important. Because they are used for a lot of things. And we can do a faceless autopsy. Sounds pleasant. Another serious blow to the aliens' efforts. Monthly supply rewards increased. Impressive. Income increased by plus 15 supplies. Alright then. So, and now we can scan. What can we do next? Back to making contact? Supplies. Not now. I do want supplies, don't get me wrong. But I kind of want to finish making contact with India, because we got started on that already. Let's do that.
Got an urgent
Incoming resistance communication. All right then.
Have made considerable progress.
Oh yeah, right. Retaliation stopped one. Guerrilla operations completed one. Council missions completed one. Resistance rumors investigated two. Okay then. Oh, dark events. Right. So the way dark events work is that you get a choice what you want to stop.
We don't have the resources.
And the aliens will get certain benefits depending on your choice. But in this case, okay, hold on.
The resistance has a hidden cache of.
Yeah, we'll make that decision once we get there, but that's basically what dark events are. You get a choice what you want to stop. And the enemies will get certain benefits based on what you did and what you didn't. Like extra armor for advent troopers. 140 supplies. Okay, I don't want to keep ignoring these things. I suppose we can finish making contact later. We only need 3 days here. 140 supplies is a lot.
Scan this region before we can establish contact with.
Okay, yeah, let's go. 140 supplies is a lot. I want that. We can finish making contact later. There's no huge rush. And I'm not going to ignore 140 supplies. Definitely not.
I do not there. Think I could have predicted this.
Oh, that's
outcome,
the autopsy, right.
It is intriguing.
Okay, then. So, battle scanner. The battle scanner provides extra vision, blah, blah, blah. I assume that's like the battle scanner from the first XCOM. As for our next research, let's do these autopsies. Because, well, we should.
To one myself. Countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
Okay, then.
I certainly admire the courage and tenacity displayed by our troops.
Commander, we've got local
right,
resistance
so,
forces waiting to make
contact. Well, that black site is still there. Obviously, we can't do that yet. Let's keep scanning. Not much else we can do, really. Do we want to make some more items? Build items. Not really, I don't think so. We could make the nanoscale vest, but here's the problem. The nanoscale vest is used instead of grenades and things
exactly.
Like that.
I'm proud of what we're doing here.
And so far, explosives have proven to be extremely useful. There, we got the supply drop. And, well, fly back to Resistance HQ. And we can finish making contact with India, I suppose. Yep, that's what we're going to do. Or we can get the other supply drop. New staff available. Oh yeah, nice. We need an engineer, we really do. Like, badly. 180 supplies. That's a lot of supplies. But we seriously need an engineer. I think we'll hire one. What are these other bonuses? Medical assistance. Resistance HQ provides extra medical staff and resources to help our soldiers recover from their injuries faster. And faster construction, I assume. Decreasing required construction time. These are kind of cheap, but I seriously want the engineer. This is a lot of supplies, but we need another engineer. We only have one. Okay, let's do it. And we can grab one of these. We could grab both if we want to. I think I'll just go for faster construction. There. And that will have to do. So, now that we have a second engineer, we can assign her here, or we could start clearing the other alien debris. I think that's a better idea. We're not in a huge rush to finish the experimental grenade, and I want to start excavating this. Finishing excavation will also give us supplies, and that is going to be useful. Okay, so what do we want to do next? I kind of want the supplies. But I also want to finish making contact with India. Let's finish making contact with India. Since we already got started on that. And this is our longer-term goal, the black site. Okay, alien debris cleared, nice. Now, do we actually have enough supplies to build something? Not really. Okay, then. Well, this is a tough choice. What can we do? We can clear more debris.
Commander, I appreciate
we will finish clearing the others on
the engineering team, but as
alien
fans,
machinery.
We have people still waiting for an assignment. We can have them working on
or we could finish that grenade faster.
Or staffing a facility.
Okay, fine. Let's finish the experimental grenade faster. I like experimental grenades. I like all kinds of grenades. You can't go wrong with grenades.
Commander, we have a
and resistance
then.
Communication. Sounds like bad news.
Hello, Commander. It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar. I believe the black site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
Okay, so that's the fail condition of XCOM 2, if the Avatar project completes. This is kind of like the doomsday clock of XCOM 2. You don't really have to worry too much about it from what I know. But yeah. As I said at the start, I've not actually played myself. It's just what I heard and what I know, that you don't have to worry about this too much. At least, not at this stage of the game. Right, so let's finish making contact already. And we got the sectoid autopsy. New item available, mind shield. New research available, psionics. I don't think we have to rush the psionics too much. And yeah, I kind of wanted to read that, but never mind. Faceless autopsy. Magnetic weapons. Maybe we should just go directly for magnetic weapons. But let's do the faceless autopsy.
To describe the difficulties we have had in attempting to handle this creature, affectionately known as the faceless.
Affectionately? I don't know if that's
the
so affectionate, but I'm just saying.
Structure, including a pliable, semi-solid outer layer, seems to be slowly degrading now that the
Look
creature
at these clothes.
Has expired. There is also a pungent odor that only seems to grow stronger as time passes.
Well, that looks pleasant. Alright, so I'm going to finish the episode in just a moment, but I want to finish making contact with India already. There. Rise of the Resistance. Achievement or something. New objective, investigate the Advent Black Site. So now we can actually do that mission. New income, 60 supplies. New region available, East Africa, East Asia. So these are regions we can make contact with. But that would cost us more supplies now. 80, or more intel, I mean. It would cost us 80 intel because this is multiplied by link distance to nearest radio relay. So we'll have to build more relays in the long run. I guess we will grab the supplies next, but that's going to happen in the next episode. Thanks for watching this one, and I'll see you next time.